This video is from my Twitch stream. There is a link in the description, or you can just follow the URL that I put on screen. Now I hope you enjoy A Hat in Time. How's the audio? Am I coming in loud and clear over the game? Is the game coming in loud and clear over me? It's A Hat in Time. Let's see, let's turn to a file. My thing is being quiet and not saying anything ever. That's my whole deal. Just start with an incredibly adorable intro, like, ugh.
And welcome to yet another day of space adventure. You are only 5 light years away from your destination, home. The fuel tank is full and the ship is flying at full speed. Today's to-do list contains waking up and adjusting.
Yeah. So yeah, when I was playing this originally, and I only got like through the first world, and oh man, this is like the dream, right? This is like the dream. Right here. Yeah. Anyway, when I was playing, like, my biggest problem with games like this is like the camera, because like, if you can't see what you're doing, then, you know, it doesn't really work. So like, it had a terrible camera. It had this on, top-down camera. So like, when you zoom out, when you like, try to look top-down, it just zooms it out, and I was like, oh no, this is terrible. But then, it turns out it was an option, and I don't know why it was on. Doesn't sound familiar at all. No, I don't know what you were. Oh, this is just sitting down. Sitting down, the game. A closet. You only really wear one outfit, so there's lots of room for skeletons. I know, right? Me too. And she has like a diving board. It's great. She has a whole spaceship. It's like a kid's dream. There's a bunch of like these watching stations. Also, like, I think. Okay. I don't know what that was. Well, it's a Roomba, but. I know, right? It's a dog TV show, too. So. We're halfway home. By the way, isn't that terrifying? There's a shadowy figure in space. Just knocking ominously.
What is this? Flying boat? All boats need to pay toll in Mafia Town, even in space. Mafia come in to collect.
I love the logic in this game. Like, yeah, clearly you have a door outside of the ship that just opened. And he's breathing in space, too. I mean, we're also breathing in space, but... I love these intro drawings. They look so awesome. No. Okay. Oh yeah, did I unbreak the camera? Yeah, I didn't. Alright. Unbroken. Mustache girl.
The fellow Mafia watched TV last night? Confusing science owls say small people can jump double in air. I saw. This makes Mafia uncomfortable with body. Must go work out.
So, this is like, I know if you've ever played like, what's going on? Okay. Just got stuck there for a second. I don't know if you've ever played Mario Sunshine specifically, but this is like straight up that. And broken camera mode is literally Mario Sunshine camera. I know, right? It really is. This jerk. Oh yeah. I can't hit anything yet. Just... Oh yeah, so like, it's pretty much that game. Just straight up, but, you know, with not Mario. It plays very similar too. I don't like her tone. That's all I have to say. Calling my cool time thingies junk. Whoa.
Follow me, Rebel Squad.
I mean, I guess in that way, it's even, like, the same premise as Sunshine. Because, like, Sunshine, pollution, you polluted the island. And this is, like, you polluted the planet.
Hey, I think one of your junk pieces fell and smashed right into the market's fountain. Messed it up real good. When going over there, just avoid making eye contact with the Mafia and you'll be fine. Good luck, fellow rebel. See ya!
Thank you. Teaching me how to dive run. In COD we trust.
Hey! Whoa.
This game teaches very wholesome lessons. You know, if there's a mafia in town, just go straight up and try killing some of them. I like it. Ooh. Cool. So, I mean, it works exactly like a Mario game. I'm gonna stop saying that, because that's pretty much what it is. Oh, my dog used to do that too. It was the funniest thing. She would just be sitting and staring. It would always be when she was staring too. Staring at like me or my mom or something. And then she would just snore. Like, what are you doing? Killing birds. Yeah! Got a runny thing. How do I use it? No, that's not it. There we go. I can literally kill everyone! Alright. I love all the little details they also put in the game, all the little posters and thing. I just feel bad that they released it like so close to the new Mario. Like, very much the same kind of like feel to it. I guess if people don't have the Switch, because barely anyone has the Switch. But no. Wait, where am I going? I have a thing. There we go. Oh yeah, okay. Just remember what I'm doing. I'm saving Mustache Girl from Mafia.
Hey, child, shoo! Mafia can't have child witness when Mafia teaching lesson. It's awkward for Mafia. Mafia not sure what to do. Boss, what do we do with eyewitness? Teach her lesson, boys.
I'm gonna take you down. Ooh! Not expecting him to get that through.
Mafia won't bow to little girl. Prepare to feel Mafia's wrath.
Yeah, he did. He did. It's deceptively a M-rated game that looks like a kids game. Eventually, they drop blue balls, so you know. Oh, it's a bouncy barrel. Wait, really? Well, at least they were able to find a Switch. As far as I heard, it's pretty hard.
Mafia need to take care of this Mafia style. Prepare to feel what Mafia do to old ladies.
Not the old ladies. easy. Oh no. Okay. I'm not gonna say it's easy too soon. Yeah, they're little, like, what do you call them? Like those. I'm not sure of the name. Let me get a good look at them. Those, like, machines that you, like, put a coin in and you spin it, and then you have, like, little very cheap toys in plastic balls. It's kind of what that is, but it has little diamonds in it. And red ones have hearts.
Can you believe them? What a bunch of losers. Hey, you're all right, new kid. Do you have a name?
Nope.
No? You shy? That's cool. You're a less talk, more fighting kind of girl, I take it. That thing you grabbed there, are you collecting them? Because I know where there's more of them. They've been raining from the sky ever since you arrived. I've seen the goons bring them to their headquarters way up there. We should go up there and get your junk. It'll be fun. I'll take any opportunity that involves messing up the Mafia.
Yeah, let's go get my junk.
You with me, buddy?
You sure? Mustache girl. Friends. We have a friend meter. This is one of those games. We have friend meters here. For some reason, like, whenever I stream, the comments are super delayed. I don't know why. I don't know if there's something to do with how I encode the stream or something like that. But it's always super delayed. I need to figure that out. I need to get Ark in here. He can figure stuff out.
Are you ready to take down some Mafia? Let's do it! I'm psyched! Let's go over the plan. All assaults need a good plan, or it'll be a flop.
Yep.
First, we strangle them, choke them, and watch them beg for mercy. That'll show them. No, wait. Strangling is too kind. We smash them together into mush and put their remains in a jar.
See, it's a wholesome fun.
Then we sell the jar for pocket money. That'll be the ultimate salt in the wound.
Yep, yes, mustache girl.
But first we have to make it through their Mafia HQ. Once we find and dethrone the Mafia boss, the rest will follow. Then our Mershon jar party will be no problem. We've got to get you geared up. Your hat is...
basic.
And we don't do basic in this gang. Yarn can be found around Mafia Town and used to stitch new hats if you're crafty. I've collected one for you. You need more yarn for some hats than others. I guess being creative isn't free, huh? So keep an eye out for yarn. Now you're a killing machine. Let's go get them.
It might be normal for some of us, you know, but like, some of us are more into the dismembering more than actual just putting them in the blender. I'm not very much of a blender kind of person. Look at that burger. Looks pretty good. Good food. But yeah, I'm not very much of a blender kind of guy. I enjoy just chopping. Chopping tends to be way more fun. But of course, as in all ways of butchering, it's an opinion. It's Oh yeah. Can do that. Can also do that.
Little girthy thing over there? Mafia wonder if there is way to get. But Mafia no time to search for entrance if Mafia need to stare.
It's kind of weird to, like, kill people that talk in a game like this. Because usually you're killing, like, little monsters or whatever. Like, here you're killing people. Bald men with aprons. And look at this guy. Has a little duck. A little duck on his hat. Not the type. Wait, what does his apron say? World's best mom. No, wait. What? Mafia, is that? Yeah. Hey, Ben. Are you living up to your name now? I don't know. They explode. Yeah, they do become stars, but they explode. Makes me wish that, you know, guts would actually go flying. To keep up with the wholesome fun that this game gives you. Doing well. How are you? I haven't talked to you in a really long time. Yeah, it's true. Yeah, this is very much like Sunshine.
It's slimy space alien! Mafia's a spaceship! Mafia knew all along! Mafia is being invaded by aliens!
Oh, it even has, I was showing it earlier, it even has the broken camera from, it's not broken, but has a terrible camera from Sunshine, and you can turn it on or off. It automatically is on, which I was really worried for a second, but then eventually, oh, I found out that that was not the case. But yes, this is very Sunshine. Very Sunshine.
Leave Mafia alone, you monster! Here, if Mafia give you this, will you go away?
I know, right? They're not trying to hide it at all. But it's great. It's awesome. This is a great game. Down with the Mafia. Yeah, take care, man. Still mud. Oh, I just need to go in here. I don't even need to do anything.
You took your time. Help me out here. Get these brutes off my case and we can go inside. Good job, kid.
Getting stronger. Taking them down with one hit. Gonna explore. Oh, I can't stand on that, huh? Game's tricking me. It's lying to me. Shows that mustache girl can stand on it, but I can't. Go away, please. Yeah, it's from the birds. No, it's from the Mafia. Oh. There it is. There it is. The tre. It's French. It's a Pokemon reference. It's a Pokemon reference. But I think they had the exact same line in Pokemon. It's a thing. Are you sleeping? Or do you do that when you're in pain? She sleeps when she's in pain. Huh, okay. That's interesting. Alright, that's not working. Ooh, I'm in the man's bathroom. Oh. Rift token. Use it on your spaceship's orb machine to gain cute rewards. Only cute rewards. I'll be the judge of that. Wait. Doors. Mafia. Also Mafia. Dance with Joy, Dancing Man, Mafia is non-union? Is that what that said? Delicious. Okay. Why, hello there! Not disturbing creature.
Hi there, young one. I am from a faraway land. I've seen every corner of the earth, and now I sell tiny pieces of my discovery. You may call me the badge seller, for I sell and trade badges. I can provide you with strong abilities and upgrades to your hat. If you have money, of course.
Yep. This is pretty good. Get all these badges. They're great. Oh, I don't have the muns. Look at this guy's face. So pleasant. Alright. Just gonna ignore that. This is the last mission I played in this game. Before, you know. I stopped because I was doing other things. And so this is as far as I went.
The Mafia are terrible at cooking, but fear not.
Cookin' Cad is here. I prepare the actual dinner up here and swap the food before anybody eats the Mafia's cooking. I'm fairly certain someone would die if they ate the Mafia prepared food.
So they're the Mafia of cooking. Well. Right trigger. Yeah. It's always a vent in these games. Checkpoint. I can't do that yet. Should have explored a little bit more. Oh, I have 100. I want to go back out. Can I go back out? No, I can't. Okay. Well, I'm screwed. Or am I? Oh, that's weird. Oh, no, it's not. Okay. All of that should be... Proceed. Okay. Nope. There we go. It's time for the bios.
So, it is you! Ever since you landed in Mafia Town, it's been raining with these magical hourglasses. You must be very lost, kid with the hat. You're in the heart of our town, standing before the most powerful man you will ever witness. Everything you've ever owned belongs to me now, including this hourglass piece. If you want it, we'll have to settle it in true Mafia style.
Cooking?
Right. Action! It is showtime!
Oh no. I already forgot how to do this.
Supercharge!
I really like that the Mafia are dressed up as trees, as scenery. It's good stuff. Oh.
Supercharge.
The fight? It's pretty chill. Like, I have to say, it's mostly because of how well this game controls. This game is really, like, responsive. So it's like, it could be very challenging and annoying to play this, but it's not, because it kind of works. I learned a lot from this game. I learned that mafias transform into balls to attack little girls. Ultra charge.
Mega charge.
Oh crap. That part is definitely a little bit more challenging. First try. Time to get some more story. Can I just leave? I can't just leave. I'm trapped here.
Anyway, are they some sort of rare collector's item for nerds? Are they some sort of rare
Yeah.
We can make it so that you never got punched in the face by the Mafia that one time. We
yeah.
can beat up the Mafia, travel back in time, and then beat him up again. No, wait. We can make it so the Mafia never arrived on the island. Wait. Even better. We could be crime-fighting time travelers.
We just want to go home, lady. We just want to go home. We want to sleep.
You have all this power, and you're not going to use it to fight.
No, we're going to sleep. Nope. Sleep.
If you're not going to use them to fight evil, then I will. I'm not going to let this island remain as Mafia Town. I'll collect all the timepieces for myself. You have my word on it!
But Mustache Girl, wait! Mustache Girl has pickpocketed half of your pawns. Enemies. Now the game becomes a gory mess. The Golden Vault. Time rift detected. I haven't seen this. I don't know what any of this is. What's a time rift? What is this? Oh, is this like a secret level somewhere? Okay. Alright. The golden tickets. Alright, this is probably gonna be the last mission I play. Unless it's impossible and I can't finish it. Where does it go? Oh, it's really far away. That was way down there. Oh, hello, you.
Please disregard my twitchy behavior.
Nope.
My body has been to places that have left a permanent mark.
I don't want to know. Yeah, this is. Yeah, I do not want to know where your body has been. Okay, so I saw one of the tickets over, like, this way. Oh, there it is. Oh, no. Well. SS, none of your business. How am I running out of air? jumping. Okay, wait. I got this. Killing birds. There's a... For some reason I haven't found it yet, but... The other playthrough, which now I have kind of gone past where I was, but... I already had another hat. I don't think I've... Yeah, I don't... I think I have enough yarns, but I need to find, like...
That darn seagull over there took my camera! I would have gone and done a belly dive over there. No, but this belly's too precious for sliding on.
Alright, I got this. Precision platforming. Press back to take pictures. Can I make it? No. Okay. I'm not very good at the whole looking at chat thing, but you're not a cheater. You just use the what are they called? What's the proper name for them? Assists or trainers? Trainers. They're just trainers. They're not cheats. They're not cheats. Wink, wink. Heavy wink. What's this? It looked like mud pie. Can I climb this? Nope. Just went through that pole. Can I not climb the pole? Can she not climb poles? I thought it was like a thing everyone that jumped did. Everyone that knows how to jump knows how to climb a pole. Okay. What's up with this? Why is it so reflective? Why do I get dirty when I... Whoa. Nothing interesting nearby. What? Hello, you. What happens if I sit next to you? Ooh, a chest. Cute. Okay, it's another relic. It's a dude sleeping. Can't kill him. Because he cheats, he becomes unbeatable when he sleeps.
All roads lead to Mafia. Not good. Big immigration problem. We fix this by moving to island. Now no road lead to Mafia.
Makes sense. Sound logic. I approve. Ooh, there's that thing. Should I go in? He's like, oh, it's gonna be my last thing. I'm not gonna play anymore. And then I... Just like with every single one of these games, you see stuff. And then... Yeah, she's not... There we go. Oh no, okay. That's the thing that's supposed to happen. Yes. This looks like, yes. Just like, exactly like the platforming challenges in Sunshine. Oh, I can do a shortcut there. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, these challenges tend to be, in all these games, very much precision platforming, which can go terribly wrong or terribly well. Whoa, okay, checkpoint, cool. Ah, no, 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 no. Okay. Come on. This is exactly like Sunshine. These platforms. Man! Originally I was actually planning to play Sunshine for this stream. But then I booted it up and hey Bob! I booted it up, and the camera was terrible, and it was inverted. Oh, what's this? Ooh, half flare, okay. Can I even get this right? It's not a thing, right? Oh, it's re-roll. I kinda want a new color. I'll go for it. Blood Moon. Okay, I am very happy with that. I like red. But yeah. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna play Sunshine. Sunshine's great. Sunshine is not great. Not anymore. Why is the cook cat here? Yes! Yes! She looks awesome. Oh!
What a lovely spaceship you have here.
I didn't know that. Well, I guess I've seen Nikki streaming. Yeah. On Discord. I completely forgot about that feature. What was this?
But I guess you aliens come in all shapes and sizes, huh?
Guess she is an alien.
You can explore our planet. You need to understand it first. Otherwise, you won't know if you're stepping on grass or quicksand. Don't know how to identify relics? Fear not. Cook and Kate is here.
Ooh.
I'll let you have this burger cushion relic for free.
All right.
You can identify this relic at the podium. If you place them on the podium in the correct order, you might be able to make sense of it. If you're able to identify a relic, something great might happen. You never know. So keep an eye out for relics. I've taught you everything I know about relics.
Is it here? Is this? This. I made a burger. This game's amazing. It lets me create burgers. It's a match. You've identified a relic from this strange planet. It's a museum now. Ooh, look at that. Yeah, I knew about like showing when people are playing games. I completely forgot about the whole streaming thing. Oh yeah, I just kind of wanted to check the new area. I'm not going to go into the next mission. I heard there was something interesting in this room. Something that I can get you guys to participate in. Is it this? Yes, the VGS-1, the fastest, most complex supercomputer ever... to be built. Boot it up? Yes. Power it on. A world of computing delight awaits you. Greetings, user. Undefined user. Welcome to your home computing experience. Open application. Fun. Open application. Games. You have selected the text-based entertainment application. Open application. Yes. You have selected yes. I will choose a game from my immeasurable library of purely non-visual fun. I have selected Corgi Quest 7, The Leashes That Bind. You are a corgi. Your name is Alan. You must sever the magical leash holding you to this plane of nastiness. Exits are north, east, and south. Do you guys have any preference? Any preference for directions I should go in? We have north, east, south. We're gonna beat Corgi, this Corgi game. And Bob, if it's only you there, it's in your hands, man. It's in your hands. The thing is, I don't think I can even see if anyone's watching me or not, because I have it open on. Go east. All right, and it's also like super delayed. I think it's like 30 seconds delayed. I think Tasha said. So you cannot actually go east. You have been tricked. You are where your quest began. Exits are north, east, and south. So north and south. All right. You go north. There is a tiger. Exits are south and advisable. We can talk tiger, bark, or go south. Or fight. We can fight the tiger. Also a possibility. Bark. All right. You bark. It is very loud and good. The tiger is unduly startled and mauls you really quite badly. Try. We lost. Okay, you're a corgi. I'm just gonna check south. What happened? You go south. There's a set of gates south. They are guarded by a prismatic. Okay, this is completely different. Do you wanna I'm just gonna go north. Do you want to keep going north or do you want to go south? I thought south would be kind of like a joke again, but it seems like both directions lead to something. Kind of crazy. Like I heard about this part and I was pretty like wondering how deep it would be. Just the simple fact that it seems to have a pretty big I'm not a pro like Nikki. I don't have the technology. My thing is literally the game screen and my voice, and I have no idea how to do anything else with the current setup that I have. And I mean, I really think it's just you, Bob, so sit back, relax, get cozy, because this is a very small stream. Actually, just because it... I'm just gonna try stuff. Just because I have a feeling that that delay is super long. So, alright. You go south. You go south. There is a set of gates south. They are guarded by a prismatic wolf. Exits are north. You can look? I'll look. There is a set of big gates. They are guarded by an impatient-looking prismatic wolf. Exits are north, bearing slightly east-ish. I'll bark. You bark. It is really quite sonorous. Sonorous, I don't know. The prismatic wolf rapidly shifts between spectrums visible and invisible. You're a dog, so you really only see two colors irregardless. So whatever, I guess. It flees, and the gates are now unguarded. It would probably come back if you left, though. I'll go south. You go through the gates and arrive at a grassy clearing. There is a large canyon here. Exits are north and south. Jump. You try to jump the canyon. It's possible you didn't know how big canyons are. Maybe that wasn't appropriately described. It was very large and measurably deep, should you possess the immense means to do so. Try again. Oh, I died. Okay, so I'm gonna try. Bark. South. Wait, can I just go south? If I go... Okay. Oh, okay. You pass a small field and arrive at the camp of a wandering blacksmith in a large field. He introduces himself as Barry. Exits are just about every direction, I guess. It's a field. Oh, look. There's a smaller field behind you and a larger one encircling you, likely in a non-threatening manner. There's a camp here, and I checked, so I can say with confidence, you think this tent is gray. Barry is here also. Exits are literally everywhere. In a sense, in another sense, you can only go north. I'll talk to Barry. You talk to Barry. I may have mentioned this earlier, but it is a stretch to describe the noises you make as talking. He offers to make you a weapon, and promptly does so. It's a sword of four dogs. You have a dog sword now. Okay, go north. You go through the gates and arrive at grassy clearing. Large canyon here. Okay, I'll look. There is a slightly dry grassy clearing. A large sweeping canyon separates it from another grassy clearing to the west. There is a character in the clearing. His name is Seven Conclusions. Jump to conclusions. You attempt to jump to conclusions, but instead make a hasty judgment without considering the facts. You plummet into the canyon for several seconds before Seven levitates you out on their side. Seven is a wizard. You are on the other side of the canyon. Seven Conclusions is... This guy's name is so confusing. Is here, dressed very badly as wizards often are. There is a wizard tower to the south, but it doesn't belong to them. There? Theirs? They both look incorrect in capital letters. Is on the plain of yellow. What? Exits are south. You could go east, but that would be swiftly followed by down. Okay, I'll talk to Seven. You make dog noises at Seven. They understand completely. Okay. The nearby wizard's tower would very likely hold a way to remove that leash, they say. There is not much else around here otherwise. They continue. It's pretty sparse out here. Look, there's a big canyon like 4 or 5 steps away. Also, a large mauve wizard tower to the south. If you went towards it, you would be traveling tower wards. Okay, 7 is here too. Dress like a... The concept of choosing clothes that looks nice together was an arcane secret far beyond their grasp. Exits are south, tower wards. It's protected by wards. Okay. Talk to 7. Okay, this is the same thing. Go south. You arrive at the tower. There are wards protecting it, and boy, are they doing that in a passable manner. 7 is here as they followed you. There isn't much else going on, they say. Exits are north. Bark. Bark seems to not work. Oh, it did work with the wolf. You bark. It is impressive on a scale that future civilizations will struggle to truly comprehend. Mm-hmm. Many scholars and academics will insist first-person accounts are fabrications, and such a bark cannot have ever occurred. 7's descendants will sue for libel successfully. Get this, 6 times. Wild, right? The wards disintegrate away into the spell weave or something. Wait, they just disintegrated? And the tower is open. Enter the tower. You enter the tower. It's airy and well lit, but that just makes it more obvious that the furniture is less a hand-picked furnishing and more a collection of needed objects that someone came to own as they became necessary. That's my house. You know what I mean? Yes, I do. They kind of match. The effort was made to pick similar darkness woods, and the styles aren't completely dissimilar. You can easily tell from the wear and tear. Some have been used longer, though, and the brackets holding the longer shelf on the wall are brass, whereas most of the other metal trimming and pieces are iron. 7 has been knocked unconscious by a bugbear while you looked at the furniture. Exits are not available, given that you're in, like, a fight. Use sword. I have a sword. You wield your sword for dogs in the manner to which you are accustomed, which actually, you know how dogs use swords, right? I don't need to describe it. You slay the bugbear. The stairs, which do not match any of the other woodwork, are unguarded. 7 is on the floor, but they're probably fine. Go up. You go up the stairs all the way to the top of the tower. There is an altar and a magic book. Exits are down in varying speeds depending on if you go a different direction first. Go... You focus your inner spirit and take in the magical energies of the book and the altar. Before speaking the word of power, you feel tangible reality slip away. In an instant, you are pushed Dennis way. I feel that that's a reference to something. You arrive in... Thank you for playing this special... of Corgi Quest 7. The leash is up behind. Closing text. Was that it? Surf the net. Unfortunately, the tide is low right now. Please check again later. Alright. No, yeah, I'm gonna end with that. I'm gonna end with Corgi Quest. Corgi Quest was a... it's a good way to end a playthrough. I can't complain after Corgi Quest. Just gonna go... I can't go back into my room? Oh no, my room's up here, right? I can't go back into my room? Can I? No. Hello, Roomba. But yeah, I think that's it. Thank you for sticking around, Bob. I hope you enjoyed Corgi Quest. And if you're also around Tasha, just hearing. Hope you also enjoyed Corgi Quest. But yeah, that's it for me tonight. Thank you for watching, guys. And hopefully I'll keep playing this game, because I'm really enjoying it. Alright, see you later.